Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Let's talk about Teams and how it can be your organization's in-out board. In fact, if you need people to know if you're available or not, if you're working in the office or working remotely or not, Teams can do that for you. So I'm going to show you how to make changes to your availability and how to find out other people's availability as well. So let's start with just your availability. So anywhere you're in Teams that has an icon for the person you're chatting with or corresponding with, you can hover beside that person to see a little bit of information about them. So this is who I'm logged in as right now, Connie at Mission Computers. And you can see I have a green check mark beside my profile picture, which is telling everybody that I'm available. And also that tomorrow looks like I'm free. Let me show you how to make changes to this availability. So within Teams, I can go to my icon, profile icon at the top here, and that's what's saying I'm available. Now it's saying that because there's nothing in my Outlook calendar saying I'm not, and I'm not in a Teams meeting or call. So in other words, this may not say available. If I'm in a Teams meeting or call, it'll show that I'm in a meeting or it'll show I'm in a call. And if my calendar in Outlook shows me as busy, this will show me as busy as well. So some stuff does carry over from other places. So let's just say I want to change it so that I'm not showing as available within Teams. I can click on where it says available and change it to busy myself. Or I can say do not disturb. Now this will mean that I will not get any pop-ups unless somebody's directly tagging me in a post or a chat. And then I've got a few more options here as well. So for our first example, let's just say do not disturb. And right away you see that icon, the red icon with the dash in it, and so will everybody else when they're chatting with me or they see my profile picture somewhere on their team screen. And it's reminding me at the top that my status is set to do not disturb. It won't always show me this at the top. It's just because it's suggesting that, you know, I may not get notifications unless it's urgent or priority. Now let's just take a peek at someone else on our team screen. So we have Connie Clark here, another person in our organization. And you see she has a yellow icon beside her picture, which as we hover on it, shows that she is away. So if I click on her icon, this tells me that she was last seen 14 minutes ago. So that really means she was last active in Teams or some Microsoft 365 application 14 minutes ago. And she now appears to be away. Now let's go back to our status. So as I hover on my picture, you'll see that it does say do not disturb, and then tomorrow I am free. So that's what everybody else will see as well. Now let's give more information about this. Let's go back up to our profile picture and let's set a status message. So what this is it lets people know a little bit more information about your status. So I can write something in my message saying, you know what, I chose do not disturb because I'm working on the proposal. And maybe I want this to actually show when people are messaging me directly. So when they're about to message me, they see this pop up when they type in my name. So that's an option. I can also say that this message itself is going to clear after some time. So right now it says today. Let's change that to say it's going to clear after 1 hour. Notice that there is an option for never, so I can always have a status message on my profile. And I also have an option for custom, meaning that I can put a particular time in there. So let's say 1 hour and then choose done. So right now it's showing working on proposal, display until 7:38. So that's 1 hour from now. And it is giving me a pencil to let me edit it further if I want to, and a garbage can to let me delete it if I don't want that message to appear. So let's just hover back on the profile as if we're somebody else, and we'll see. Yes, when we check it out, do not disturb is definitely on there, but there is a message. And if someone were to type in my name to chat with me or to send me a message within the team, then they would see working on proposal will pop up. Now, another option that I have is if I'm saying it's only going to be for the next hour that I want this do not disturb on, rather than me keeping track of the time, I can go to my profile at the top here and go into the do not disturb where I pick that status. And then at the bottom there, I have a duration. So I can click on this And I can say reset the status after what time. So kind of like the same as the message idea. And this time I can say 1 hour. And again, I've got a few other options, 30 minutes, custom. So custom would let me pick an actual time, but we'll choose 1 hour and then done. So it will reset itself. And this will be based on what my calendar says. Am I available in my calendar in 1 hour, or am I busy or in a meeting? Okay, so let's reset that status so we can do something else with it. I'm gonna go back up here and I'm gonna delete the message. And then where it says do not disturb, I'm just gonna say reset status, which just means read my calendar and show my status according to whether I'm available or busy. Okay, so according to my calendar, I'm available. So let's go and check that out. So right now it shows that there's nothing on my calendar and I'm not in a Teams meeting and I haven't changed my status within Teams. So I'm gonna open up Outlook. I'm in the calendar in Outlook. And let's say that I have an appointment at this time. In fact, we'll make it for an hour here. And notice that it changed the status for me to red, saying that I am busy. It doesn't say I'm in a meeting. It doesn't say I'm in a call. It just says I'm busy because it's reading my Outlook calendar. Now let's go back to Connie over here, the other person in our organization. And let's say we want to chat with her. So if I click on this bubble here, that will take me into the chat window and right into her chat that I've already started some time ago so I can continue the chat here. Right, so that was a fast way for me to chat with somebody by hovering around their name and picking that little chat bubble, which threw me into the chat screen, right? So this icon here. I'm gonna go back, use the back button here to where I was. And let's do this again. Let's go back to Connie and let's try the send a quick message and see what it does this time. All right, so I've typed a quick message and this time it didn't throw me into the chat window. So there is a difference between these two. This quick message lets me stay where I am, whereas this chat one lets me actually start a chat or continue a chat with that person. Now, if I wanted to call or email Connie, I can use one of these options below here, as these are hyperlinks that will open up an email message for me so I can email Connie directly or open up a phone option so I can phone her directly. Now, another thing we have as an option is if we can't get a hold of the right person to ask a question, we can actually go to this little icon here, which is the org chart, and that will let us see the org chart in terms of where this person sits so we can maybe contact other people. So I'm going to click on this for Connie. That takes me back into that chat window, by the way, but into the organization tab. And now it shows me for this person that I can't really get a hold of right now, who is her supervisor? So who does she report to? Parallel. And they seem to be offline, by the way. The little X says they're offline. And then who reports to them? And that's Connie at Mission Computers. And they are busy right now. And if I hover on that person, you'll see that information. But sometimes this org chart can be handy because, you know, you may not be out of luck like I am here. You might have lots of people to choose from. And so if you can't get hold of the person that you need to directly, maybe there's somebody else that they report to or that's in the same level as them that you can ask your question to. Now let's go back. And a couple of other things you need to know about this availability. And so in terms of being able to let people know, you know, really, are you available? Where are you? You can actually go into the profile here. Beside where it says a status, in this case, busy, you see another little icon with a plus sign in it. We're gonna click on that. And that's where you see your ability to tell everybody, are you working in the office today or are you working remotely? So if I choose remote, it changes my button at the top here to have a little house on it. And now if I was somebody else and I hovered on my profile picture, it will show busy, but then it will show that I'm working remote. So it's just kind of getting used to what these little icons mean. And if I hover on there, it does say working remotely. So you see how much information you can give others based on whether you're filling in your Outlook calendar, based on whether you're changing your status in Teams, based on whether you're in a meeting in Teams. People know if you're available or not. People know whether you're working in the office or working remotely. So let's just make sure that we keep this up to date, though. That's the little catch here. Because some of it is automatic. Some of it we do have to change. So this working remotely will reset itself tomorrow. If I don't change it today, it'll continue to say work remotely today. But tomorrow it will clear itself out again so that it won't show working remotely. So I would have to change that from day to day if I am working remotely. If I go back up here and I want to reset this right now, it does have clear location as available because I picked something. Previously, it didn't have that because nothing was chosen. So let's just clear the location. Okay, now the last thing I need to tell you in terms of making sure you keep everybody else up to date on availability, and hopefully they keep you up to date as well, is that the time you have set in your Outlook calendar will reflect whether you are in the office or out of the office. So what I mean by that is I'm opening my Outlook calendar again. It might be hard to see the shading, but the 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. from that time frame, it seems to be a bit whiter here. These are the working hours as shown in Outlook. So Outlook will have a default in terms of what working hours it thinks you're at. And if you've never changed it, that's what it's telling everybody else. It might be giving people the wrong information about your availability. So let's make sure we change this to reflect what our working hours really are. So go into the File menu in Outlook, and then go to Options at the bottom, and then choose Calendar, and then that's where you're gonna choose your start and end time. So right now, I'm actually looking at a different account here, but it's showing 9 to 4, so let's just change it to say, I'm coming in later, it'll be 10 to 3 we'll change it to, so it's really obvious. And I'm not showing, and I'm only showing it on Monday to Friday, so Sunday and Saturday will show me as unavailable or really out of the office. And we'll choose OK to that. So now if you notice the white area, it's showing from 10 to 3. So that if that was really my work hours, then before 10 a.m., after 3 p.m., it'll show I'm out of the office. Now, if I happen to still be working within Teams or on some of my Microsoft 365 applications, it'll show I'm out of the office, but it could also show I'm available because it sees me working. So just be careful of that one. If you see out of office and available at the same time, that just means somebody's working outside of their working hours. All right, so some things to keep in mind. Try and keep your status as accurate as possible. Help everybody else. Put your picture there by clicking on the icon that might have your initials right now and upload a picture so everybody knows what you look like. And give people the right information so they know how to get a hold of you. All right, so try all that out. Thanks. Bye-bye.